Welcome back. You're still watching Logo. The scorching summer has barely set in and cola makers are already slugging it out. To be sure, Pepsi and Coca-Cola are rolling out TVC after TVC this summer.
The heat is clearly on and it's not only the mainstay cola brands that are getting their thrust. Even smaller brands like Slice and Maaza are getting the much needed thrust. Let's find out more.
Carbonated drinks may rule the market, but cola makers are now closely paying attention to other categories, particularly juice-based drinks. Recently, PepsiCo unveiled a host of ads for brands like Slice, Mountain Dew and 7-Up. Not to be left behind, Coca-Cola, which has two juice-based brands, Maaza and Minute Maid, is launching newer variants for its Minute Maid brand. For long, the battle of Coke versus Pepsi was fought by the mainstay carbonated brands, sometimes on supermarket shelves and other times on advertising campaigns. Why now are companies bucking the trend? PepsiCo India's director Homi Bhatiwala attributes the fact that Slice just happens to be the fastest growing category.
The mango drinks category has been the fastest growing category, in a standalone format for now more than 4 to 5 years. It's been on an explosive growth track. We've seen the category grow in excess of 25 to 30% now for the last 4 years. It stands on its own. It's a very relevant category.
Indeed, Bhatiwala has a point. According to industry estimates, the juices and juice drinks categories growing at a compounded annual growth rate of 25% in the last 3 years, while carbonated drinks have been showing signs of losing fizz to healthier drinks. So it's not surprising that Coca-Cola and Pepsi are pushing healthier juice-based drinks. As part of this, Slice has come out with a new campaign featuring Katrina Kaif with the catchline "Sabr ka phal meeta hota hai."
Gehri sunehre pe rang thehrne do, behak ye mehakne do, kyunki sabr ka phal meeta hota hai.
The new campaign, Bhatiwala says, follows a two-pronged strategy.
We've already kicked off our marketing campaign behind Slice for this year. In fact, we're very excited because we've rolled out a pretty unprecedented campaign behind the brand. A couple of parts to the campaign. One is we've broken our entire thematic communication, continuing our Aam Sutra series of advertisements. But what we've done is we've taken it one step forward. What we've done this time is we've latched onto a new insight, an insight which is very Indian, which talks about how waiting heightens pleasure as brought alive through Sabr ka phal meetha hota hai. And it's a very mango insight because when you wait for the best mangoes to ripen, that's what goes into every bottle of Slice. The second big initiative for us was that we've launched a new SKU. It's a 350 ml bottle which we've called the Handy Pack.
Mountain Dew ka Salman ko challenge.
It's not mango-based drinks alone. Pepsi is pushing even other soft drink brands like Mountain Dew and 7-Up. With big ambitions for both brands, new campaigns have been rolled out with new brand ambassadors. While Mountain Dew has roped in Salman Khan to market its brand,
Dar se mat daro, dar ke aage badho, Mountain Dew.
7-Up will be using actor Sharman Joshi to do the needful.
7-Up, gussa hatao, chill machao.
So why is Pepsi scaling up investments on smaller brands?
Both brands are extremely important for us in our portfolio. Dew as a brand has been growing share and is the fastest growing brand. 7-Up is a large soft drink brand within our portfolio. It's the second largest brand after Pepsi.
With an increased focus on newer categories, brands are also undertaking several on-ground activities. Coca-Cola, for instance, is partnering with Future Group's Big Bazaar, wherein the country's largest retailer will stock Minute Maid exclusively for a day before it reaches other retailers. PepsiCo is also doing massive on-ground exercises.
We've kicked off a very ambitious experiential sampling program, which is rolled out across 4 regions in India. And we hope to reach out to about 1.5 million consumers in the next 45 to 60 days. And it's a sampling lounge on wheels. It's not just, standing outside a shop and making people taste the product. It's about experiencing the pleasure that you get out of having Slice.
Mountain Dew 2 is relying on some heavy on-ground initiatives.
We have a very aggressive plan lined up for experiential sampling. We have a very interesting idea called the extreme fall. Some lucky consumers can actually free fall from a 50 feet height on a crane, and they can carry back souvenirs. So apart from sampling the product, they can get some great new merchandise.
It's clear that both PepsiCo and Coca-Cola have been investing heavily in their non-carbonated portfolio. Late last year, Coca-Cola launched Maaza Milky Delight, its entry into the dairy segment, and soon after followed that up with an iced tea brand called Nestea. And all this in a matter of less than a year.
Trying to catch up with the pace the consumers are requesting new products. So there's so much going on in the market here, and consumers are so eager to try new things in life, and beverage is just another part of their lives. So they've been asking us to do a lot more. And I wish I could have done 20, but this is the right pace for our business and for consumers to understand all the brands.
So where does this leave the carbonated drinks? Company executives at both Pepsi and Coca-Cola maintain that their summer strategies are still in the offing.
And to think that the summer has only just begun. Expect more action in that space, and we'll continue to keep you updated. On that note, it's a wrap on Logo this week. Thank you so much for watching. If you've got any feedback for us, please write into us. Our email ID is logo@utvmoney.com. You can also get in touch with us on Facebook and Twitter. Our IDs are flashing on your screens.
In case you wish to see a repeat telecast of the show, the same is also available on our Facebook page, Bloomberg UTV Logo. Until then, goodbye.